How are you feeling?
I'm feeling fine.
Good.
Yeah.
You look good.
As you can see, I spent the weekend...
You've been clipping it, yes.
Well, I just sent one to Bill Benton, the Secretary of Education. There is one in here. It's the story of a family of a four-year-old boy and the problems they had when he started school, kindergarten, with him being shuffled into one of these special education classes that we fund. And this went school after school. And they were having these problems, and what developed here, the kid's as normal as anything in the world, but how quickly, just the slightest thing, change schools, same thing would happen. And what comes out of it is that we're funding a program in which evidently a lot of teachers at the lower grades have just found that to hell with it. If a kid presents any kind of a problem to them at all, they can shuffle them off.
Yeah, I hung out there for Israel.
Oh, but yeah, but the last night, the usual trick, they were having this meeting. They had to sit through 25 speeches. And all of these were speeches by non-voting representatives. And this was all pressing again on these same things that we're against, about trying to get a vote on a consensus on some things, you know, like Palestine and everything else. And I guess Murray, when everyone was in the press, moved in, well, as this, it didn't, and he said, everyone that's talking is a non-voter. We have won. And so I guess they can
tell you this is part of it.
Packing everything. Caricature, and of course all these young Navy nurses, they objected.
I gotta mention that.
So before I left the hospital, I told them that I would make it my first task to change the image among the cartoonists. Here.
Well, they're very good, those nurses are.
Yes, they are.
We're blessed in that regard.
Well, listen, I'm so pleased to welcome you and so grateful for what you're doing and appreciate very much your very kind, fine letter. And I know I don't have to say you said it in the letter. Yes, we're following a man who set quite a standard.
I think I'm getting even more admiration for him. Mr. President, I'm getting more familiar with what he does. I'm quite intimidated by the whole process.
Well, I know we've got some problems that we've had and that have continued. For example, I think we still have a task of...
Centennial Commission.
Oh,
that's an impressive group. Geez, so I hadn't heard of the reverberation.
The House will be for you. It's the Senate where the quibbles will be.
Well, we decided on a thing yesterday because, you know, all weekend, everybody, including the Harlem people, were saying, I've got to get into it. It's up to me now. Well, so up to me, I called. I told him there was no way I could get the tax increase, not after the campaign and all the things that he said. And it was my impression after the meeting in the patio here that everybody had agreed that, led by Tip, the other side, was saying Social Security was off the table. Mm-hmm. So I said to Bob, I'm gonna go with no tax increase and no freezing of Social Security codes. And if anything suggests that the Social
Security code.
Star WHTV, that's all I have there tomorrow.
My daughter came home last night. Those were quite some exciting times in that room. But I guess we won.
did a terrific job. There's a message in also from our ambassador in Somalia. She went by and saw President Siad, and Siad's comment about Maureen was that if he had his way, he'd like to hijack her for about another 10 days. But the embassy said that this was probably the most effective high-level visit we'd had by any American official in 10 years.
For heaven's sake. Well, she, there's a, is it the foreign minister? There's someone of Egypt, though. And I guess she really had a run-in. There's some from Egypt who are just fine. But this guy, he's there and he gets loaded along about lunchtime. And she said it was the same performance of the last meeting they had. And then there came a time when she had met with him for an hour and explained, told him something that was going on and everything. Then one took the action. He sat there and was raising hell about it and denied that he knew anything about it. That he shouldn't have said to her. She says, I sat in this same chair and talked to you for an hour about this. And she said, and I don't like being called a liar by you or anyone else. And I guess they really went at it, nose to nose.
I don't think it'd be their foreign minister. I hope not. Because he's pretty well used. McGee is a good name. That must be somebody.
That doesn't sound right.
Situation and why I made the call yesterday that I made about a bill. When this first proposal this came up with the tax increase, including and the proposal on Social Security, and when I was told about it, I was also asked if I hold my fire and not say anything for a couple of days, and I did. And then over the weekend, with all the talk shows and everything, began to be increasingly the quota, so that I needed to be heard from. And it seemed to me that they had made it clear, and in our patio meeting out here, made it very clear that Social Security in any form was off the table. And therefore, we had to look someplace else. And several of us on the meeting was breaking up, voiced aloud our belief that, well, okay, if that is so, then certainly there is some compensation due to make up for that. And when we met the other day after the old treaty, the same thing, but they were still in that position. And it seemed to me that it was time, if the conference was going to get going forward, that here was the major issue up here, But what we ought to get settled on is the difference between the two, the House and the Senate proposals on the spending cuts. And if we could get the other out of the way and say, here's where the problem lies. So I called them and told them that there just was no way. And I was terrified at the thought of perhaps having to wait and then be the stupid picnic if something came out of the conference with regard to including tax increases. And I'd just like to remind you of the campaign in 84. One of the debates was almost entirely on that. Mondale was calling me a liar and saying that I too would have to increase tax, only I was not going to admit it until after the campaign was over, after the election and so forth. And there's just no way that I could make that reversal. And now accept the tax increase. Besides which, I believe, more than just personally, I believe that a tax increase, again, is a threat to the continued recovery that we have had and would risk putting us into recession number 10 since World War II. Now, as I say, I included the Social Security thing, and I'll give you my reason for including it. Some years ago, Lyndon Johnson put Social Security into the budget. It was an independent program. It still is an independent program. For us to be in the same, he did it to make the deficit look smaller. Because while the outgo would have to be added, the income from the Social Security tax would have to be added. And that was bigger than the outgo. So on paper, it made the deficit look smaller. But not one dime of that surplus can be used to reduce the deficit. That money goes into the Social Security Trust Fund. And first of all, I think that what we were doing was giving the Democrats what Tip O'Neill wanted above everything else, which was a campaign issue. And he'd really be using it in 86 against us, as they had in 82 and tried in 84. Now, the truth of the matter is, since the commission met to finally bail Social Security out to put it on a sounder basis, included in that agreement was that in 1992, Social Security will be taken out of the budget and put back where it was as an independent program. I think that maybe, not as a part of this now, but I think before long, we ought to advance that and take it out. Because it is, and we were in the position of deceiving the public. For us to go forward and say there's X billions of dollars in savings over 3 years if we change the COLA situation in Social Security, not only are we handing over an issue that they used against us, but we're deceiving the people as Lyndon Johnson did, because we're not going to cut that deficit by that amount, except on paper. Not a penny of it could be used to really reduce the overspending that is going on to the year-on-year deficit. So my own idea was, okay, let's take these two off. Let's call attention to the fact that we have come a long way to meet them on the other major issue, which is defense spending. Now, we in turn have a right to ask them for some more sensible approach to the spending items. And the funny thing is, they're not too far apart. Dave has given me a 3-year total. What are savings from the baseline over the 3 years? In the major hard savings, non-poverty, things like rural housing, export-import, and postal subsidies, mass transit, Amtrak, all of these things. In that list of about 60. Yes, I am. I feel so proud of myself.
Right? So you feel so good about how you feel.
You don't want to overdo it now. This is where we're at. Thank you very much.
Now, I should have sat at the other end. I know, but you've got the buttons there.
Which ones?
Which buttons? I was just the
Yeah, that's a good question.
Oh, thank you.
Great. How is that? Is your wife doing all right now?
Yes, fine.
She sure.
I just got a letter of encouragement here. A woman sent a lovely snapshot of herself. And the Tuttles had wanted me to send this woman a picture of California on her 100th birthday.
I did. And the snapshot is her, 100 years old, dressed in lovely gown, on her way out to a party. And they enclosed a note to them from her, just as, you know, a wonderful note and so forth. 100 years old, 30 years ago, she had the same operation. Kind of encouraging.
Encouraging.
Guess you had a great team of surgeons, didn't you?
They were wonderful. They really were. And I must say, all of them, the orderlies and the nurses and all, it was...
You know, the NIH man, I think I told Don, I know I told Bob Dole, my neighbor, immediate neighbor that I've been friends now with for 8 years, is an NIH researcher, MD, PhD. And about 8 months ago, he had a little operation. I said, who did that? He said, the best surgeon in the United States. I said, who's that?
Rosenberg.
I said, what do you know about it? He said, I know him personally. Really, the 7 or 8 major cancer operations a day. Research?
No, the surgeon, this is the head of surgery at Bethesda, invited him. He's just there as an observer in the
room. He's the one.
Yeah.
So he was an observer.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where's the wave?
Breaking on the show. Watch the questions now. Watch the questions. Huh? Press for them.
Oh, all right.
Hi there.
How are you doing?
But everybody's back, and they're all back at work. So, they're come back with the doctor.
You did. Just fine.
You gonna get a budget? You think you'll get a budget?
Well, I am, as always, cautiously optimistic.
True, you said you didn't want to be something at a picnic? As reported in the morning press?
Oh, I used that a couple of times.
Will the United States be moving towards some sort of sanctions?
Now, we're taking questions. This is the photo line. We're supposed to be talking about the women of the world. I've been hearing about the success of the UN Women's Decade Conference this time. It's most gratifying.
Good.
Well, I'm going to bed.
Have a good day.
All right.
Okay.
Whose coffee you want?
Mine?
Have you recovered from the time?
I don't think so.
Oh, you don't?
I just work on my clock.
Everything I...
Well, listen, thank you very much for your help the other day.
I'm going to talk to you about first.
I'm trying to look for it.
I guess we've all come to order. Who's in charge?
Mr. President, we have two issues today. One is the farm bill, and the other is agricultural credit policy. And Jack is going to start out by giving us an overview of the status of the farm bill legislation.
Mr. President, to start with, we'll review the situation in agriculture today. And I think the environment that we're trying to write the farm bill in is really a problem. Very depressing. The exports are down 25%. Interest rates for many, if not most farmers, are going up instead of coming down. Prices are very low, almost across the board.